We are going to start the weigh-in.
Ash, answer the phone!
Hello.
Where's he at?
Just hold him off. Tell him I'm coming.
He's on the bicycle.
No, dummy, is wait. What weight's he at?
Where you at, Vinny?
I'm coming!
He's coming.
Everybody!
Got a little surprise for you.
140 pounds even. Yeah!
Tomorrow night, you're gone.
I'm gonna rain on you like a thunderstorm.
I feel like I should be on a box of Wheaties doing a Gatorade commercial.
Jessica Fitted from Entertainment Affair with Aaron Egger. So nice to see you. I'm a fan, and a lot of our viewers are fans of yours too. So.
Thank you very much. Hello.
Bleed for this. What an interesting character. I have to say, I was so surprised. The way your physical transformation and just something that we haven't seen you play before.
Totally different.
Yeah.
I've gained weight before in my career, but this was gaining weight, shaving the head, putting the plastic tube up the nose. And
wow.
Then doing that, you know, Staten Island broken nose boxer accent.
That was so cool.
Which just scared the you know what out of me.
Yeah.
But we had such a good support unit. We had such, well, I mean, we were in Rhode Island. We were with the fans of Vinny Pazienza.
Wow.
You know, we were walking down the street, and he's a rock star in Rhode Island.
Absolutely.
So everybody had a story. We had the full support. This movie was filmed in the venues where it actually took place originally.
That's interesting.
And so the authenticity was off the charts. And Miles totally committed. Everybody, Ted Levine and Kieran Hines, Peggy Seagal. We all lived in, we didn't live in the apartment, but we spent the days, all our dressing rooms and everything were in that little house, you know, so. You know, you'd be up in your dressing room and you'd smell the smell of spaghetti wafting through. You'd hear the voices,
nice.
You know, what was going on. And then you'd go down all together and shoot the scene. So you really felt like a family.
Mm-hmm.
And all that bickering, you know, that you're doing. And so it was special in that sense. It was a very short shoot. It was 24 days.
Wow,
so
that's it?
Yeah, we had to hustle. We didn't have many takes and no rehearsal. So luckily, Miles and I had been in a movie before together.
Yes.
And so we knew each other, so we didn't have to go through that first day of school, you know, thing with each other.
Yeah.
And we developed, you know, that sort of sacred bond that a fighter trainer develops that's necessary.
And you can see that on the screen, too. It's just, it's played so well with the both of you. Are you guys crossing fingers for nominations for the awards?
I'll vote for Miles for sure. I get a vote.
Okay. His performance was off the charts, right?
Yeah, he was fantastic.
Yeah.
And just, you know, I mean, it's a beautiful role,
mm-hmm.
and he does so well in it. And everybody in the cast, for Ben, it was so well written. It's a little gem.
Yeah. Yeah, no, definitely. And as an actor, I asked the same thing to Miles. His character, Vinny, he gets a question from a reporter. What lies have you been told about the business?
Mm.
And I'm wondering, what lies have you been told
about the acting business?
Yes.
What lies have I been told
yes.
about the acting business? Well, the biggest lie about the acting business is you can't make it in the acting business.
You can't make it in the acting
business? You can't make it in the acting business.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Care to elaborate on that?
Yeah, I mean, you know, this movie's about inspiration. It's about following your dreams. It's about believing in yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Well, the acting business is the same. It seems like such an impossible dream that everybody tries to talk you out of it when you want to be an actor.
Absolutely.
And it always blows my mind. My kids will come up to me and say, I say, well, what's your dream? I want to be an actor. Well, why aren't you an actor? Because my this doesn't want me to, or this, that. I go, why are you listening to them? Go live your own life, you know? Make it happen. Do what you have to do. Live your dream. And so there's no such thing as you can't make it in this business.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to make it, you'll make it.
Don't let the feelings get the better of you, okay? You don't have to slug with this guy, all right? What? What is it?
He don't hit like a girl at all.
Jesus Christ.
Actually, it's pretty hot.
Vinny, move your head. All right, come on. Kick it.
this!
I know that you worked a long time ago, and not that long. I wouldn't want to give
no, a long time. I'm 48. It's
wow,
been a long
look,
time.
You look so good.
48.
Rum Diary in Puerto Rico.
Yeah. I Puerto Rico loved it. Puerto Rico?
Yes, a lot of our people are from Puerto Rico from entertainment.
Yeah, I surfed my brains out in Puerto Rico because I had some time off, so I would go down the coast and surf, or surf right outside my hotel. I also, you know, the greatest thing about Puerto Rico is I would drive down south in the coast, and I would find my own private cove.
Nice.
And so I would go spend the day and swim in this most beautiful ocean, the beach, and I would eat the, what are the dip things?
Mayo ketchup?
Yeah. The pinchos. I would eat pinchos all day. And I was hanging with the locals.
Oh, nice.
Oh, yeah. I had a good time.
Rincon?
No, I went to Rincon to surf. But this was, what is Rincon? That's west.
Yeah.
So I would go east, and I found my own private cove.
Look at you.
Yeah.
That's so cool.
Oh, I had a blast.
Well, they're telling me to wrap this up, but I can sit here and talk to you all day. This has been such a pleasure, Aaron.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for your time.
I want you to understand the difference between a risk and a gamble.
Yeah, risk, gambles, whatever.
No, not whatever. This, what we do here, this is calculated, okay? We weigh the odds, we make a choice. This ain't blackjack, Vinny. It ain't orange juice and tit jobs and sunglasses. This is it. This is it!
Do you think I'm gonna lose this fight?
No.
Good. Me neither.